In my teaching, I found that art helps illuminate and bring home important theological issues and theological topics. Today, I want to look at a piece of art that's on the cover of my book, Centered in God, the Trinity and Christian Spirituality. And it is the Old Testament Trinity by Andrey Rublev. Andrey Rublev was a Russian Orthodox iconographer, and this icon dates back to the early 15th century. It's called the Old Testament Trinity because it's taken from Genesis 18 and also chapter 19, where these three visitors come to Abraham. In the Eastern Orthodox tradition, you're not supposed to make an icon of the Father and the Spirit. They never became incarnate like the Son. You can make an icon of the Son. So what Rublev did was to go to that image there in Genesis 18, where these three visitors come to Abraham, and use that as an attempt to somehow illustrate the Christian vision of God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And not only that, but to also show how the Trinity even changes the way we think about Christian salvation. So let's talk a little bit about the icon. One of the real weaknesses of this icon is when you look at it at first, it looks like there are three gods, right? So Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You have the Father on the left, the Son in the middle, the Spirit on the right. But that's not the Christian understanding of God as Trinity. There's one God who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And Rublev understood that. So if we can just put that aside for a moment, what this icon does do, and this is a real strength of it, is it shows us the community of love in the Godhead. And so here you have Father, Son, and Holy Spirit who are seated at a table together, enjoying fellowship with one another. On their eyes, if you can see that, and it may not be clear here, but their eyes are looking at each other. So the Father looks at the Spirit and the Son. The Son is looking at the Father and the Spirit. The Spirit looks at the Son and the Father. And then one interesting thing just to note as well is that both the Son and the Spirit have their heads bowed in deference to the Father and the will of the Father. But they're sitting together at this table of communion. Another thing that emphasizes their communion is if you look at this line that you have between the Father, and just watch where my finger goes here. I'm going to go down here, the side of the Father, and over here to the side of the Spirit, and look at the space in between. So all the space in between here, you have another communion chalice, another cup, again emphasizing the community, the divine love within the Godhead. Again, if you just trace between the outside of the Father up to the Spirit and the space in between, you have a second chalice or second cup of communion. So again, this icon emphasizes the community of love within the Godhead, but it also is an image of Christian salvation. And to explain how that's the case, it may be helpful just to talk a little bit about how icons work. A lot of times when we think of art today, we think of perspective and images from the Renaissance. In the Renaissance, in those perspectival images, you're really kind of drawn into the painting and into what's going on kind of behind the painting. So maybe there's a scene of a field and you found yourself drawn into the field that's in the painting. Well, icons, really the action isn't behind the painting. You're not drawn into it. Really, the action, if I'm the viewer, it's between me and the icon. So you may have seen some icons that are just an image of a face that's just staring at you. Well, the action there is between me and that icon, that person that's staring back at me. The same way here, the action that's taking place is between me, the viewer, and this icon. And so if we think about, now I'm standing here looking at the icon, there's a couple of interesting features. One is there's a space here at this table that is for us, the viewer. I don't know if you've ever been in a situation where there's a circle of friends talking and you wanted to join that circle and there's no opening. There's no place for you to jump in and join the conversation. That can be a little awkward. But here, there's an opening. There's a space for us, the viewer, at the table. Not only that, this cup, this chalice is toward us. And there's an invitation to us to come and to enjoy and to participate in the divine life. Another thing, if you look at the Father and the Spirit, they're open to us. They say body language is important. So if I'm standing like this, this is an open body language. If I'm standing like this, not very inviting, right? But the Father and the Spirit here are open to us, and we're invited to come and share in the divine life and the divine community of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And really, as we think about Christian salvation, that really is central. This is a uniquely Christian way of thinking of salvation. We've received God's Holy Spirit. In Christ, we've been reconciled to the Father. We are sons of God in Christ. The relationship that Christ shares with the Father is now ours. And so there's all these images in the New Testament of Christian salvation where we're being brought into the divine community of God. And so in this icon, again, we have both an image of the Christian understanding of God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, but also a powerful image of Christian salvation as communion with God.